Hey, you. Is that contraband in your pants? Or are you happy to see us? Because we're the Masters of Boarddom, and today we're going to show you Sheriff of Nottingham.
You definitely want to smuggle this into your collection. Sheriff of Nottingham is all about making your friends sweat while you bluff and negotiate your way through whether or not I'm going to need to search your bag, sir.
Yeah, you might be carrying all sorts of contraband and weapons for Robin Hood and his merry men, and I'm not standing for that, see?
Unless you happen to have a little coin for me.
Yeah.
Sure is warm out here, could use a cold beverage, perhaps.
Just think of it as a fee.
So, Sheriff of Nottingham is a bluffing and negotiation game with elements of set collection and hand management. You gotta be real sure about what cards you're gonna put into your bag every single turn. And sometimes luck may force your hand.
And a few coins, of course.
And always smooth things over. Or maybe not.
It helps to know who you're playing with and know how your friends act when they're the sheriff and when they're the honest merchant.
Oh yeah.
So, but playing with new people is fun too. I say good day, merchant.
Yes, good morning, sheriff.
What do you have to claim today?
One bushel of very fine apples.
Very fine apples. I'm sorry, did your basket of apples just begar?
No, I farted.
Yes, I see. It's a lot of bagasse. On your way!
So, let's go over a standard round of play. Each player gets 6 cards in their hand. Oh my! They may or may not want to keep those cards. For example, if one just so happens to have an entire handful of contraband...
Whatever do you mean?
I couldn't possibly be carrying all this
contraband. I'm a humble apple merchant.
Every round starts with a mulligan, so anyone who wants to dump up to 5 cards from their hand may do so, as long as they are not currently the sheriff. Now, they can pick up these cards either from the discard pile or from the pile of face-down cards in the deck. Either one, and they can even do a mix of both if they wish. But once they've done one mulligan, that's it. They're stuck with that hand, and they need to decide which of those cards are going to go into their bag.
I'll be putting this bag full of cheese together.
Oh, really? How much cheese is that?
There happens to be exactly 3 cheeses, Sheriff Aaron.
Wow. I don't buy it, but we'll see.
I happen to have these extra coins that are cluttering up my coin purse.
Oh, goodness.
And I was wondering if maybe you could buy yourself a beverage at the tavern when you make it back to town this evening.
I could. I do so hate cluttering coins. So once the players decide how many goods they're going to put into each bag, they have to declare one type of good and up to 5 of those goods. You have to say the number of cards that you actually put into your bag, and you have to name one type of good. Now, what can you actually put in your bag? Anything you want. Any combination. Legal goods, illegal goods, just throw them all in there. But when you declare, you must declare one type of good and up to 5, however many cards you put in there, that many. So
once you do that, you get to decide whether or not you're going to bribe the sheriff.
Yes.
Now, the sheriff can search your bag if they want. And if they find the red contraband cards in there, you have to pony up the dough. If you get caught with all legal tender, the sheriff must pay you.
Yeah.
So you can either bribe him to not search your bag, or bribe him to get him to search your bag. In either case, it all depends on what you stuck in there, and the person you're playing against.
Yeah. See, I never trust CJ, because I know better. So I'm going to disregard that paltry 2 coin.
But
offer.
Sir!
I don't think so.
I am a cheese merchant!
Yeah, I somewhat doubt it. I will look inside his bag and, oh my, this doesn't look like cheese at all. Oh my goodness.
My assistant filled the cart.
Oh, did he now? Well, as it turns out, I have found a cart full of contraband.
I don't know how those got there. They're not mine.
Only one actual cheese was in there. Anything that he declared that was actually in there, he does get to keep. So enjoy that cheese for what good is
worth. Hooray!
However, every contraband card that I caught him with, he has to pay a penalty on. And let's see, that's 4, that's 8, that's 12 coins, please. And to make matters worse, he doesn't get to keep them. They go bye-bye. So he lost a lot more than 12 coins just now.
Sheriff Aaron, we've been receiving some complaints lately.
Now why on earth would that be?
You can't just cavity search everyone in Nottingham.
Why not? I was clearly made to do this. This is my calling.
What makes you so special? What makes you think you have the right? Egad.
And then there's the other possibility. Say it's my turn here, and I'm just gonna put these 5 apples into my bag. Nothing illegal whatsoever about this. 5 apples. And you know what? It does seem awfully hot today, Sheriff CJ. Maybe a little something-something would help smooth your way. To sweeten the pot, because I know you're a hard-working man. I know you've got things to do, better things to do than check all
these. I do have an empty coin purse suddenly.
You know, I feel bad about that, so I'm actually going to offer you one of my goods that I took in a previous round. That's a legal move. I could also offer him something in the bag. I will give you one of my apples if you choose not to check this bag.
Now,
of course, if I offer him something in the bag and it turns out it's not actually in there, he doesn't get anything and I got away scot-free.
Charlatan!
But players will remember that, so it will impact your future deals.
The sheriff will make its way around the table twice in a game, and
twice in a game with 4 or 5 players.
That's true.
With 3 players, it goes around 3 times. Anyway. So, 5 apples, and you get to keep one of the apples if you don't check my bag. What do you think?
I have an overabundance of apples here, and as much as I'd like to add to that pile, I find it unlikely that you have 5 apples. Five apples?
Harumph!
On an apple cart?
I'm an apple merchant. What would you expect to see?
Sir, I believe that you are lying to me. And I wish it was true!
Sir, you have now checked my bag and found there to be exactly 5 apples, and I have now been kept away from market for too long, and I have lost profits, and I demand you do something about it, or I will speak to your superior!
There's no need to start an internal investigation. I will pay you for your time.
Yes.
Subsequently, when the sheriff searches someone and finds only legal goods, they must pay them...
Well, legal goods and the goods, only the goods that they declared.
That's true. If you had a rooster in there, you wouldn't...
You wouldn't pay me anything, and I would pay you. But since he found exactly what I declared in that bag, habunga!
I'd like some change, at least.
Yeah, you can have that. Anyway, so that's the basic gist of it. There's more to it, but at the end of the game, whichever player has amassed the most money between goods and coins is the winner. So being a good sheriff and being a sneaky merchant is key to winning this game. Also, set collection. Because at the very end of the game, players are going to get bonuses if they happen to have cornered the market on particular types of goods. For example, CJ has more apples than I do, even with my bag full of 5 apples. He's got 6. So if this were the end of the game, he would get a 20-coin bonus. But
huzzah!
Since there's a bonus for second place as well, I would get 10 for my 5. And so on and so forth. The breads and the cheeses are worth 15 and 10, and the chickens are worth 10 and 5. But individually, chickens are worth way more, double what apples are, so...
Your contraband remains secret throughout the game, placed at the top of the player board. Some contraband is worth bonus cards at the end, such as apples or chickens.
Yep.
And subsequently, there can be end bonuses that you don't even know about until the very end.
In fact, right here, golden apples considered contraband, but counts as 3 apples at the end of the game.
So if you manage to sneak it through, you might just take that apple market after all.
Mm-hmm.
So what it comes down to with Sheriff of Nottingham is, if you enjoy social games where you get to BS your way around the table, this is the game for you. It's a fantastically good time. We've played it at least a dozen times, and I can't think of a single time that it wasn't an absolute blast. It's not even about winning sometimes, it's just about messing with your friends, throwing coins on things to get other people searched. I mean, not that that ever happens.
Not that that ever happens.
No,
never.
Now, Sheriff Nottingham is a fantastic game for people who enjoy deceiving their friends. And oh boy, is it a thrill when you get away with something. One of my first games, I managed to sneak through an entire bag of contraband. Every single card was contraband. It was huge. It must have been worth at least 50 points. And I was thrilled, and that feeling stuck with me. And so every game I've been trying to replicate that moment since. But sometimes it bites you in the behind.
Never.
And that can be fun too.
For everyone else.
Yeah.
It's a really, really fun game. I've always enjoyed this. It's always a lot of laughter. And
so much laughs. Especially if you put a little bit of energy into role-playing the sheriff and the honest merchants. You will have a blast trying to make up excuses to sneak by. It's so much fun.
I absolutely have memories of many rounds where nobody tried to sneak anything through. Nobody was putting bribes on any of the bags, no matter how much I tried to get them to. You know, so I feel like sometimes I just don't have the luck needed to get those big sheriff rounds that other people seem to have so much success at getting. And then other times I just pick one person who seems like they're lying to me, and I nail them. And that alone feels great. So, you know, take it as you will. But, you know, the people who are the best at reading their friends and understanding the manipulation going on there are going to succeed the best.
When you see the beads of sweat welling up on someone's forehead, you're pretty sure they're carrying some contraband in there, but not everybody's so easy to read. Or sometimes they're purposely acting suspicious, and it makes you want to dive into their bag, but if you pull out a handful of legal goods, you're going to find your pockets empty. And it comes down to having coins at the end. If everybody plays straight-laced, you're going to find your sheriff round is kind of pockets empty, which has happened to me on more than one occasion. Other times, like when I play with Matt, he and I know we're sneaking contraband past each other. We have an agreement. A gentlemanly, here's 5 coins, let's not talk about this, I'll be on my way, officer. Yeah. And sometimes it bites me and sometimes it bites him, but it's a lot of fun regardless.
Well, you bring up a good point. One of the things I don't like about the game is the fact that all it really takes is one bad round, and you may have difficulty getting back up on your feet.
That's very true.
In our playthrough, I had one particularly really bad round in which I not only had to pay a penalty, but I also lost the money I would have gotten for those goods. So in a single round, I lost somewhere between 42 and 45 coins.
You know how you avoid that, Aaron?
That's hard to recover from.
Maybe if you were a good merchant with legal tender.
What I'm saying is sometimes you can dig yourself into a hole that's not easy to get out of. And
yeah.
At that point, you're no longer playing to win. You're just playing to have a good time. And that's fine. You know, there's enjoyment to be had in that, too. But it can be a bummer from time to time, if things don't go your way.
I've seen this game played where someone goes completely straight-laced and uses no contraband and wins the game.
Yeah.
I've seen sheriffs hardly get any goods by, but rake in the money strictly through bribery. And I've seen some not-so-honest people sneak tons of contraband through and steal the game. No matter how you play it, no matter how you balance those 3 qualities, this game's a blast, and it's a little different every time because the way your friends play it is different.
Yeah, you're never going to nail down a single strategy that's going to win the game for you every time because it's about how well you can read your friends. It's about how well your friends can read you. There's real psychology to this game, and sometimes it pays off and sometimes it doesn't. The last time CJ and I played a game, I picked up on a cue, something he said, and I was like, why would he say that unless he was trying to get me to act in a certain way? And I did manage to catch him that particular round.
Yeah.
So it's all about how well you know your friends, and sometimes how well you don't know them, to be honest, because sometimes even the quietest, gentlest person can sneak through a huge bag of contraband. Everybody goes, what? It's amazing. It's amazing.
Sometimes it's not about what you want to put in your purse. Sometimes it's what you have in your hand. Sometimes you throw away a cheese and a contraband hoping to get a couple more chickens and you draw 3 more contraband. What are you supposed to do? How's a merchant to make an honest living if he has nothing but black market goods available to his cart?
Yeah, sometimes that does happen. I wound up with one hand that I can recall. It was like two different legal goods, like a cheese and an apple, and four different contraband. I threw away five of those cards and got back almost the exact same hand. What do you, the only choices are to either try and lie and sneak some of that contraband through, especially if it's versus a person you know knows you well. You know, that might be a tricky choice to make. Or your other option is to just claim one good in your bag that does you absolutely no good concerning the end of the game. A single good is not going to tip the scales, although sometimes it's come close.
Yeah, that's true. We have had some close games, and a lot of times it comes down to the contraband you have snuck through, especially when it comes for bonus endgame points, which Aaron very cleverly was awarding me chickens to sneak through his contraband, and despite that, ended up having more chickens than me in the end because of his contraband chicken, his prized rooster, as it were.
Yeah.
Well played, sir.
The deals you make are going to be just as important as the lies you manage to slip past people.
Yes.
So, you know, if you're paying attention to things like that, you can really steal some points in the end game. But that kind of situation is rare. I just happened to know that I was literally one legal chicken behind him. And I said, this is perfect. I'm going to sneak this deal through because I know I've got chickens.
It worked out perfect.
It worked out like a charm. But like I said, it's rare when that happens, but it feels good.
Let's talk about the quality of the components. These cards are pretty solid. In fact, they're probably among the best cards I've seen in a board game. Like, we've played through these many, many, many times, and they're not really even starting to wear.
Yeah, even after tons of shuffles, the cards are actually an immensely...
Or stick together. I'm a jerk, and I should have sleeved these things. I honestly should have, because we play it so often. But I haven't, and yet they're still not sticking together. They're still easy to
There's
shuffle.
No real boxing on the edges or anything.
Easy to deal with. Yeah, they're in great shape, all things considered, for how many plays of this game we've gotten in. So absolutely 100%, the cards are awesome.
The coins in the game are pretty standard cardboard fare. There's 50 pieces, there's 20 pieces, fives, and of course the singles, which is what I'm usually dealing with.
Yeah. They're fairly thick cardboard, all things considered, but there aren't many burrs on them. They popped out pretty easily when I was popping them out of the cardboard sheets, although they didn't erupt without their burrs, like this one. Every now and then some of them got a little bit of a burr on them, but otherwise not bad.
So, the rulebook is pretty good, all things considered. It's about 14 pages long, which is a bit longer than I usually like my rulebooks.
That being said, it has a lot of artwork in it. Just like the box and the characters, it's full of really unique drawings. Everything's got a lot of pizzazz to it, and I feel like that adds a little bit of entertainment to it.
Yeah, look at that girl. She's sassy. I'm Sassy Girl. Mm-hmm. I'm getting my goods past the sheriff right now.
Also available in the instruction book is instructions, along with a lot of examples of gameplay, which is super important when you're playing a card game.
I should hope a rule book would have instructions.
You never know.
This is true.
Sheriff of Nottingham comes with bags for your always legal tender, and they're really nice velvety. They have a snap on them. The cards fit perfectly in there. Although, I'm always kind of leery of snapping them, because I feel like at some point tugging on these is going to break the snap. And since you're going to open them at every single round, we just usually kind of fold them over and leave them that way. But the quality is really nice, and it has the logo of the game right on the front of the pouch. Very, very coin purse-y.
Yeah, I don't know what he's talking about. I do the snap every single time. Although I do admit a little bit of trepidation when unsnapping it. I always try and get my fingernails in there to make sure it doesn't, like, you know, accidentally rip the fabric. But so far it hasn't even come close.
The material's top notch.
It's probably fine, and they managed to print the name of the game on the front of each bag, so that's cute. But yeah, these are pretty quality made. I might want a little bit sturdier, maybe a little. But otherwise, you know, it's no complaints. Everything works great, so...
Yeah, even after all these gameplays, there's really no wear and tear on them. All the seams are still in perfect order,
yeah.
So...
And the box is pretty heavy, for all things considered. It's extremely, well-detailed in the printing. Like, everything looks great, and it feels solid.
And I managed to sneak the expansion in here. Everything fits, which is kind of nice. The only complaint I have is with the sheriff himself. Like, this poor guy, like, he's just kind of leaning back, leaning way back, because he doesn't quite sit right in his little...
What are you talking about? Oh, no! My legs have fallen out from underneath me!
I kind of wish this was, I don't know, a miniature? No, that would be too much, really.
Yeah.
I don't know, something stronger than what he's currently got, which is just...
Nothing a little wood glue can't fix?
I guess, but it's just...
I agree. It as you pass him around the table, it's like, oh, here's the sheriff. Oh, no.
That being said, as far as the sheriff goes, the artwork on the box, the sheriff standee, and even the instruction book, the artwork is flawless for this character. Tell me that this does not look like some pompous medieval upperclassman who is here to solidify your marriage with your wife.
Oh, God. Yeah, this guy... This guy, you would not trust this guy with anything.
Like walking your dog, running a gas station, running America. Like this guy, he is the skeeziest of the skeezy.
Easy to hate.
Wearing this giant, I mean, it's amazing. He looks like a pig, he's got this piggish face, he's wearing these obnoxious things. This is amazing characterization, and it goes for every character on these boards. Look at this guy. Hey, how you doing? I got the breads for you. They're here, and I'm gonna sell them to you. Yeah. Hey, my name's Tony. Tony's a wackadoo. How you feeling? I can sell you bread all day. How you like a croissant? Here you go.
The boards not only have a spot for you to put all of the cards on, it has the turn order on there, and like Aaron said, the artwork's fantastic. You really feel like role-playing the game, and that adds a lot of fun to an otherwise really simple game. So that's it for Sheriff of Nottingham. It's a great game that's fun to play with your friends.
Hey. What's the word?
The word is beguiling.
Oh, beguiling is the perfect word for this game. You're going to be beguiling your friends. The game is going to beguile you. You're going to be having a fantastic time even while you're being deceived and lied to. I promise you, you will enjoy playing Sheriff Nottingham with your friends and or family, whether or not they're always telling the truth. Who knows? But it's going to be fun regardless.
Who would lie?
I don't know. Who on earth would lie to me?
I would never beguile you, my friend.
Of course not.
Well, it's been fun.
Yes, it's been a wonderful day. Thank you so much for your kind patronage, Sheriff. But I really appreciate you.
Hey. What happened to the apples I brought over?
Nothing.
There was a full bushel of apples, Aaron.
They farted. I gotta go. Bye.
Forget.